since I saw you.
You're listening to TNCRadio.live, Houston, Texas. This station is owned and operated by EMCSICO LLC, a privately held Texas corporation.
What is dedication?
The thing that drives me every day as a dad is Dariano. We call him Day Day for short. Every day he's hungry for something, whether it's attention, affection, knowledge. And there's this huge responsibility in making sure that when he's no longer under my wing, that he's a good person. I want him to be able to sit back one day and go, we worked together, we did a good job.
That's dedication. Find out more at fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Emergency responders in the Houston area said they responded to reports of damage and stranded motorists after a tornado moved through the area Tuesday.
Structural damage from a tornado in Pasadena, about 15 miles southeast of Houston, is catastrophic, according to the local police chief. In my 25 years here, this is probably the worst damage I've seen, Chief Josh Bruger told reporters outside a damaged animal shelter in the city, where two dogs were injured. Haley White reporting.
With threatening phone calls, burned minibuses, and at least three drivers shot to death, street gangs more closely associated with Central America are imposing their brand of terror-based extortion on public transportation drivers in southern Mexico.
Organized crime groups, including the rival Mara Salvatruca and Barrio 18 gangs, have long maintained a presence along the border between Mexico and Guatemala. But Mexican authorities say their numbers have increased over the past year as El Salvador cracks down on gang members and their criminal enterprises. Torvi Rodriguez reporting.
U.S. President Joe Biden announced that the U.S. plans to send 31 Abrams tanks to Ukraine after Germany confirmed it will deliver 14 Leopard 2 tanks from its own stock to the country.
The announcements mark a landmark moment that followed weeks of intense pressure on Berlin from some of its NATO allies. Ukraine's President Zelensky praised Germany's announcement Wednesday as Russia's ambassador to Germany said Berlin's decision takes the conflict to a new level of confrontation. Harry Michaels reporting.
A suspect was taken into custody in connection with an overnight shooting that left three people dead in Washington state, Yakima Police Chief Matt Murray said in a video on Facebook.
Murray said officers responded to a phone call from a family member of the suspected gunman, who said they could find him behind some warehouses. Gunshots were heard when police arrived and a man was hurt, but no officers had fired at the suspect and no officers were injured, according to Murray. Roger Cantor reporting.
This is the latest news headlines. A Louisiana State University student who died after she was hit by a car on her way home from a local bar was allegedly raped shortly before the fatal crash, authorities said. The East Baton Rouge Sheriff's Office arrested four people on Monday, including three teenagers, in connection with the alleged sexual assault. 29-year-old Madison Brooks was struck by a car while on the roadway early on January 15th and died at the local hospital, authorities said. The driver, who was determined not to be impaired and contacted emergency personnel immediately, has not been charged. At least three presidents, a vice president, a secretary of state, an attorney general. The mishandling of classified documents is not a problem unique to President Joe Biden and former President Donald Trump. The matter of classified records and who exactly has hung on to them got more complicated Tuesday as news surfaced that former Vice President Mike Pence also had such records in his possession after he left office. Like Biden, Pence willingly turned them over to authorities after they were discovered during a search he requested, according to his lawyer and aides. In a country with more guns than people and one emerging from 3 years of isolation, stress, and infighting amid the pandemic, Americans are beginning 2023 with a steady barrage of mass slaughter. Americans have come to endure mass shootings in churches and grocery stores, at concerts and office parks, and inside homes of friends and neighbors. The violence is blamed on hatred towards other communities, grievances within a group, secrets within families, and bitterness among colleagues. But it often ends when a man with a grudge grabs a gun. The U.S. Justice Department accused Alphabet Incorporated's Google of abusing its dominance in digital advertising, threatened to dismantle a key business at the heart of one of Silicon Valley's most successful internet companies. The government said Google should be forced to sell its Ad Manager suite, tackling a business that generated about 12% of Google's revenue in 2021, but also plays a vital role in the search engine and cloud companies' overall sales. And that's the latest news headlines. I'm Alan Edwards.
Kathy DeCaro is nothing short of amazing. She not only drives the world's biggest truck as a heavy equipment operator in northern Alberta, Canada. She's an international motivational speaker and the author of Dream Big, an autobiography about overcoming a lifetime of trauma and abuse that led to dreams of success. Kathy inspires people the world over to change their lives and improve their self-worth. Her book will change your life. She's passionate about personal growth and believes anyone can change their circumstances and overcome their obstacles if they believe in themselves. Her life will amaze you and seriously inspire you. Be sure to order a copy of her book, Dream Big, on Amazon.com.
Hey, what's up? This is Logan Mize, and you are listening to TNCRadio.live.
Catch Landline now every night at 11 p.m. Eastern Time, along with an encore presentation weekdays at noon, right here on TNCRadio.live.
Welcome in, TNCRadio.live. This is Highway Fever with Charlie Claiborne. And now, here's Charlie.
Hey, good evening, everybody. Another fine Thursday evening. Yours truly made it home to Biloxi. I'm going to be home till Monday. Tonight, we've got two special guests. We've got Candace Rivers, who most of you know as Miss Fit Possible, and Mike Lombard from Mike Lombard Trucking on TikTok, both great influencers when it comes to driver health. Look, we have a demanding job physically, mentally, emotionally. And during the preview before the show, Candace was talking a little bit about the life expectancy of a truck driver. So I'm going to let Candace and Mike introduce themselves quick, and then we're going to have a little discussion that Tom wants to have here tonight about a couple of issues that recently came up. So it's going to be a fun show. But Candace, good evening, darling. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you to everybody that's listening. I hope that you know just how much you matter right where you're sitting, standing, or you're at, that you're loved and you absolutely matter. And thank you, Charlie, Tom, and Michael for having me as a part of y'all's guest.
Michael, how are you this evening, my good friend?
I'm doing great, Charlie. Thanks for asking. Just like you, I myself made it back home too safely. I've been gone for all of January, and I finally made it back to the house tonight in Central Texas. So, and I'm glad to be here with all of you guys, and glad to be here to talk with Candace again as well.
So, the two of you have something in common, something amazing, something awesome in common. You both strive to see the drivers healthier, and both of you believe that in order for them to be healthy, they need to be fit. And if they're fit and they're healthy and they're taking care of themselves, their mental health is also important. Stress, a lot of other factors. But Candace, just quick, what was that number you were given? What's the life expectancy of a truck driver today?
So, with a deep breath, it's one of those things that I don't want to say this as a fear, right? Because we have enough fear in our lives.
Absolutely.
But one of the things, my mission, when I was put on this mission, and for anybody listening, I always tell everybody, eat the meat and spit out the bones with anything I say. Don't throw out the whole steak just because there might be a bone in there that you don't like. So I pray that anything I say that resonates, you keep, and everything that you don't, you just throw it away. But today, one of the things that we were talking about before we came on was one of the biggest things that impacted me when I started to learn about the things in the trucking. And one of the first things I Googled and that popped up was the life expectancy of an average truck driver. And that number has gotten better. It was 57 when I Googled it 3 years ago. Now it's 59. So the average truck driver right now's life expectancy is sitting at 59 years old. That is 17 years less than the average American's life expectancy. When I saw that number, my mission at that point was to do what I could do in my capacity to help bridge that gap. Because with everything that truckers do, how selfless they are, and how much they make sure this world keeps rolling, they deserve every year that every person they serve gets here on earth so that they can be able to enjoy their family, enjoy their life, and not just have those extra years, but thrive with them in it. And I think that's why Mike, he's a rock star. You know, he's the superstar.
Yes, he is.
Because he's, you know, I'm not out in the seat every day. I'm not out fighting everything that truck drivers have to fight. My fight, I'm a cheerleader for truckers, right? But he is, and he's showing that you can do it. And he's probably a little bit like me. I don't want to put words in his mouth, but fitness saved my life. It has been a friend to me that was sent by God when I couldn't turn to anything for stress or hurt or had wherever I was at, I could go and get a workout. I could go for a walk, and it instantly made things a little bit better, even if everything wasn't. And for me, that's why I want, you know, fitness is such a big part of helping truckers get healthier, happier, and know just how much they matter, because they give so much to everybody else. But the most important thing in trucking isn't the truck. It's not the rules. It's not the laws. It's not the companies. It's that driver that's holding that steering wheel and making sure the world keeps rolling. And I just want to make sure they know that they matter and help encourage them to do a little bit more for themselves in the process.
And you both have kind of a little bit different styles, where you're a little soft-spoken, and you, like you said, you're not doing what Mike's doing, right? So if you've watched Mike's videos recently, it's 28 degrees outside, and this man has on a sweatshirt, a beanie, and he's going for a jog. That's mm-hmm. how dedicated he is to his own health. But, Mike, so you and Candace both agree that exercise and physical fitness helps relieve stress. It helps your overall health. But, I mean, just talk to me quick. What motivates you to do what you what's your drive for being out there trying to get drivers healthy and trying, because you help them through apps and through a lot of other things. What's your motivation?
Yeah, I mean, I'd say one of my biggest motivations is a lot of what Candace said is, you know, I know the stats. You know, this job, you know, it's a chosen profession. You know, I am here by choice. And the thing is, when it comes to making that choice, you know, you could be reducing years off of your life just by making that decision of becoming a truck driver. And that's everybody out there. So that number one, that just sits in top of my head is I'm doing a job, which is similar to anybody who works in an office environment as well, because I have my friend and my business.
And things didn't work out. I was down on my luck. Got tired of roaming and
get
bumming
out of this
around.
Office chair for 11 hours, maybe just use the bathroom. And so when you're in that line of work, you have to know, you know, sitting is the new smoking. Like that's the best way to put it. So when you get into that lifestyle, so I already know that off the bat. Another thing that's probably one of my biggest drives, though, I mean, I have a lot of fear because I used to be unhealthier. I was down a road that involved a lot more alcohol, eating unhealthier, poorer habits, and how I felt, you know, with my, you know, getting bad sleep. You know, I've been down that road before. And to go back down that road is frightening. And now with the job that I have, especially because I own my own truck, and to put myself in that type of risk of not having the energy to, you know, to do the job, any, all of those things, those are definitely key factors that probably are what get me outside and to at least go for a walk. What drives me to do, you know, to go above and beyond that is just, you know, I just want to be better than I was yesterday. I want to stack on top of, you know, the progress that I'm making in fitness. But overall, it's just, you know, that's what really drives me is that when I get home, I want to have energy. You know, when I hopefully, you know, can retire one day, I want to be able to enjoy retirement. I would like to go see the world. I would like to go see some of these mountains and, you know, to the places I couldn't travel to because of the months I spent on the road. You know, that's what I'm looking towards. It's just, I almost look at it like a 401k, you know, that I'm investing in myself. So that way in the long term, it pays off.
Absolutely.
So, Candace, before we go into our next break, we got about 2 minutes. Just kind of give me the top three health issues that most truck drivers face. And then we'll talk about a little bit more after the break. The top three issues that are serious for truck drivers that we can fix. Healthy issues.
We absolutely can. I think the first thing is self-worth. Since I've been in this industry and really trying to learn the most about it, I'm not an industry as a driver, but just immerse myself in the mission. I realize that truck drivers are absolutely probably the most selfless people I've ever met in my life. And the side note, they're probably the most funniest. I think the truck drivers have one of the best sense of humors out there. But so it's knowing that they're self-worth. Because once you know how valuable you are, you'll do more to take care of yourself. And I think in a world that's dominant men, and there's still a lot of women that are starting to come into the industry and are in the industry, taking time for you and realizing the best way that you can love your neighbor is learning how to love yourself and making sure that you're taking care of you so that you can better take care of those people that you're being so selfless for. So that would be the first thing, is realizing your value. Second would be knowing that small steps count. And a lot of times they're task oriented from one place to another destination, getting somewhere and keeping the task ahead of you. But making sure that you look at what you're doing and know that you can put baby steps into what you're doing and getting out of that seat when you can get out of it, taking a few extra steps during your pre-trip, your post-trip to make that difference. And then planning ahead for your meals. It's everything to do with how you eat as well. And I know it's not easy, but it's absolutely able to add some healthy things into your eating. And it all comes from just like you plan your trip to get to where you're going, planning your day to make sure that you have the nutrients for yourself as well.
That's fantastic. And I tell you what, we're going to take a break right now. We're going to be back in just a couple of minutes. You're listening to TNC Radio.live. This is Highway Fever with Charlie Claiborne. Stay tuned.
The St. Christopher Truckers Relief Fund is excited to once again offer its diabetes prevention program. This free CDC-approved year-long program begins February 7th with live webinars focusing on nutrition, movement, stress management, sleep, and more. Sponsored by Southern Recipe, this program is for those at risk, not already diagnosed with diabetes. Visit our website at truckersfund.org. Take the risk assessment located under the Health and Wellness tab and register today.
You're listening to TNC Radio.live. Remember to tune into the Truckers Network Show with Shelley Johnson, weekdays at 3 p.m. Central, 4 p.m. Eastern.
Welcome back. TNC Radio.live. This is Highway Fever. Now here's Charlie.
Yeah, here's Charlie. Everybody says, where'd Charlie go? But you know what? My producer grabs the ball and saves the day once again. Had a little boo-boo with my phone there. But we're back with Candace and Mike. And right before the break happened, Candace was talking a little bit about self-worth, about in order to be healthy, you've got to be healthy all around. And Tom was saying during the break, and Candace agrees, and I'm sure everybody does, that mind, body, and soul. You have those three things, your health, you can only prosper. So, Mike, I need to ask you a question. You work with an app that helps people and kind of like a trainer through an app. Can you tell me a little bit about how that works, what you do and who you do it with?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's awesome how they kind of came into my life, too. I work on the First Form app, and First Form is a health and nutrition company out of St. Louis, Missouri. Awesome company. You can they're a sponsor of St. Louis Blues. You can go get their energy drinks at hockey games. But anyways, they have a really phenomenal app that they've invested a lot of money in that comes with live streams, workout plans, a whole bunch of stuff. But it also has a great feature on the app to track your nutrition, as well as track your steps and log your workouts. So you can log all of your activity and what you're eating on there. And it'll actually calculate based off of your height and weight and activity level, what you should be eating based off of your calorie intake, protein, carbs, fats, those macronutrients. And then at the same time, I work on that app as an advisor. So I have all access to some of the drivers I work with. I could see their workouts, see how many, you know, the steps they're getting, see what they're eating. And I'm there for any sort of, you know, support they need to lean on. And then the app is also there for support as well, with all of the classes and videos and anything they need. And basically I'll help guys just like set goals, and basically I'll talk to them one-on-one, figure out what they're doing, what their life is, you know, especially where they're at, because everybody's at a certain different skill level, and I'll come up with a plan for them. So, you know, because you can't just, you know, as much as people might want to off the rip, you know, they might see a TikTok video where they see me going for a run. Hey, not everybody can go run a mile straight like that, especially drivers who haven't exercised in a while. So I'll come up with a plan with them to be like, hey, at least four times this week, get in a 45-minute walk, you know, 4 days a week. And I'll work with everybody on a case-by-case basis on that app as an advisor. I'm not a certified personal trainer. I don't have any specific credentials. I just want to put that out there, but I'm there as a coach because I've gone through it too. And I'm on there to lead by example and to show them, you know, the process, and that, because it's a system where if they can meet me halfway, it'll change their life.
Absolutely. And you, in fact, have had some conversations with some of the drivers, and they've told you what a difference it's made. So it works if you put in the work, right?
Oh yes, I just had a conversation with one of a friend of mine. I met him at a Love's truck stop in Richmond, Indiana, some months ago, about a couple months before Thanksgiving, and his entire life has changed. This is a guy who, you know, and all he's really done, the only thing he really changed is he cut out regular soda, and he started going for walks. And he saw the scale move, and now this guy has his own workout routine. He's got his own weighted vest. I mean, his entire life has changed. The guy's, you know, he's so motivated in a lot of ways. He's journaling himself, like he's reading more books. Like all these, so much has happened in his life that has trickled down just from him, you know, jumping on board with me on the First Form app and working with me and keeping in touch with me and, you know, asking me questions. All of that has changed his entire life. And in the long run, it's going to help him with whatever he wants to do. I mean, he's a father who goes home to four children, and now he's got the energy to play, you know, to play with them and hang out the whole time he's home.
Woo! So, I'm excited.
So in the fitness world, would you say it's like everything else? Most people want instant gratification. Do a lot of people get discouraged because they expect too much too quick from these changes to from the way they're eating and not exercising and not getting around and not taking time to breathe and maybe read a book instead of, you know, watching TV? Is it the same with fitness? Do people struggle with that same thing because they don't see results right away? They get discouraged and walk away?
Oh, without a doubt. I that's the number one reason why, you know, the new year, new me thing always falls off, because people want that 21-day fad diet to work for them. They need this, you know, they want a quick turnaround. I think the Amazons of the world and the streaming services have kind of ruined our psyche that way. You know, everything is on demand at the touch of our thumb on some of these phones. And when we don't get it, you know, when we, you know, cause we see, oh my God, I put in all this effort for 5 days and it won't move, or I've been working out for a few weeks, but you know, I still did XYZ on the weekends. How come it's not working as fast as it used to? And really it's a brick by brick process that, you know, constantly takes work and constantly takes training to get to certain levels, you know, to do these goals. You think about it, you know, even in the trucking industry, you talk to guys, people will always talk about how many years they've been out here over the road. and that, you know, they use that experience. They talk in the terms of years, and to get good at fitness and good at your health, it takes constant practice. It takes constant work to get to that skill level or the health level that you feel comfortable with.
Can either one of you answer a question for me? Because I'm sure there's other people besides me that are just not up to par with their knowledge. What is the difference between carbs and calories? What, either one of you, can you break that down for me?
You want the truth?
Yeah, of course.
People make things difficult, okay? Everybody wants to make money. So the new this, the new that, the new this and that, and all this other stuff, the basics are always going to be the basics. And the fact of the matter is, food is fuel. Just like every tank on every semi, depending on the size, can only take so much fuel in that tank. The size of your body, if your a Honda Civic is not going to be able to keep the same amount of gas as a diesel truck. But that is exactly what food is. And the more, once you know what your fuel is supposed to be, your tank, that's how much you're supposed to get. And if you go over it, it doesn't matter. If you go over it with sugar, carbs, fruit, doesn't matter. Those calories, the more they add up and they go over what you're supposed to, that fuel is going to spill everywhere. And that food's going to do the same. The calories are. And it's one of those things. A lot of times people are like, well, I don't want to have to track it. I don't want to have to do this. Well, here's the thing. You probably don't want to have to go pull over and get gas because it's inconvenience. But if you don't, you're going to end up on the side of the road empty, broke down. It's okay to learn how much your body needs. That's the biggest thing you need to do. Metabolic rate. And you can look that. If you're listening, you can Google, what is my metabolic rate for my goal weight? Not an unrealistic body weight. Not your when you were born, 5 pounds, 6 ounces. Okay. You're never going to go back to your original weight. All right. To a realistic weight, and that, and then learning, either download in first form. You got MyFitnessPal, which is a free app, Lose It app, which is a free app that will help you know exactly how many calories and will help you track it for absolutely free. And once you do that for about a week or 2 weeks, it's easy to learn how much you're supposed to eat, where you are over consuming calories from, whether it was from carbs, whether it's from sugar, whether it's from fruit, whether it's from whatever it was. Food's not your enemy, it's your friend. And what I've learned over, I've been doing this fitness for 20 years as a career. I've been in the fitness industry. And here's the thing that I've learned. When in life, nothing is constant. Relationships aren't constant. Your money's not constant. Your job's not constant. Nothing is constant besides God and food. And when we all search for some type of constant in our life, and the one thing that most people can rely on is food. Because if you go to McDonald's and you order a number one and it wasn't like the one that you wanted, you can send it back and get the one that you did. Well, if you call your wife and she's in a bad mood, you can't tell her to hang up and call me back hang up the phone and her be in a better one.
Amen.
Can't do that. You know, same thing with your husband, same thing with your kids, same thing with your job. So food has become everybody's comfort and their constant. And I'm one of those eat the meat, spit out the bones. Even if you don't believe in God, I'm going to tell you this. When you find a place in God to where he becomes your constant and you don't have to rely on people or food to make sure that you have your North Star, which is what he is, it will help you in every area of your life because you won't need other things to get everything you need because you'll have it already inside of you. And then you're going to be able to really look at the things that were pacifying you and not really healing you, even though they might have been a friend. They're frenemies. And just, you know, don't let all the fluff get you off course. Find out how much fuel you need for your body. And it doesn't matter. Yes, we need you to eat more fruits. Yes, we need more of this, more of that. But if you stay in your calorie range and you cut out just a little bit, but first just shoot for the calorie range, you're going to see your body change and you're going to see your life getting better because you're going to be able to carry the weight that God puts you on this earth to be able to carry. He said he'll never put more on you than you can bear. So if you're carrying more than you can bear, he didn't put it there. You probably did. But here's the thing. We serve a good God that will take the extra weight off your shoulders and help you carry it with you. And I just want you to hear my voice to know that you're not too far. You're not too gone. And that step in the right direction is the best step that you can take. And it doesn't matter how many times you got to keep taking that first step. Keep taking it. Because a righteous man falls down 7 times and he gets up 8. What does that mean? Doesn't matter how many times you fall down, as long as you get up more than you did, you fell down. And if you felt like you're down today, I want to encourage you. You're not hearing my voice for no reason. Today is the day that you get up.
And there you have it. You couldn't have said it better. You never break a rock on the first strike with a hammer. So, awesome, Candace. I mean, that's why I dig you. That's why I enjoy following you and Michael. Common sense, healthy, spiritual. It's amazing. Guys, you're listening to TNC Radio. This is Highway Fever. My guest tonight, Candace Rivers, Miss Fit Possible, Mike Lombard from Lombard Trucking, both health and wellness gurus in my book. We're going to go to a quick break. We'll come right back after the break, and we're going to have a little conversation with our producer about something that recently happened that may change the face of trucking. So thank you for tuning in. This is Highway Fever on TNC Radio. We'll be right back after the break.
Hi, I'm Dr. Christopher Corcoran, and now for the Mental Health Minute. Have you ever had one of those days where you just don't feel like going to the gym? I haven't had one of those since last night, I guess. Yeah, they happen. They happen to all of us. And I want to talk about some options we have when that should happen. I like to think we have 4 basic categories of responses, of choices we could make. For me, it's easy when I say to myself, this is not an option, it's mandatory. My workouts are mandatory. They're scheduled just like my patients, and I would not dare to stand up a patient, and I don't miss my workouts. It's very easy for me that way. It's in my head. That's how I think about it, and that's how it gets done. But, you know, I ran into a guy in the gym who said, I'm having one of those days, but I'm here, and I'm just not going to work myself very hard. I'm here, and I'm going to do a few sets, and that's enough for me today. And then I read some things recently who said, you know, if you have a day like that and you don't feel like going in, you don't have to go. That's the third option. You can say to yourself, you get a day off today. And a fourth option is you can do something else. You can go for a bike ride or a swim or go for a walk or, you know, whatever it is you want to do. Just to research the same, move. Just move. But most importantly is what you say to yourself. And I'm always going to encourage you to talk to yourself like you would a child that you love or a friend that you care about. And say, it's okay. It's all right. These things happen. And when you fall off the bike, you got to just get back on. The next day, get back to the gym and just pick up where you left off.
Join Tom Kelly and the rest of the team each day on the Morning Grind. Then stay tuned for an encore presentation of last night's Landline Now. Weekdays on TNCRadio.live.
Welcome back in TNCRadio.live. This is Highway Fever. Here's Charlie.
Hey, everybody. Good Thursday evening. You've been listening to Highway Fever. Our special guest tonight is Candace Rivers, Miss Fit Possible on TikTok, and Mike Lombard, Lombard Trucking. You can find him. Guys, do you have any other social media presence where people can they can find and follow you? I'll start with you, Mike. Where can people find you?
Oh, yeah. You can find me on YouTube, right on there, Lombard Trucking. I've been posting, I post little YouTube, my shorts there, as well as on, you know, from Instagram and TikTok. You can find me on Instagram and TikTok at Lombard Trucking. And you can also find my podcast, wherever you get your podcast, the Lombard Trucking Show on Spotify, Apple, And I've been posting recent videos to YouTube as well. I'm on Facebook too, but that's basically where you can find me. If you can search Lombard Trucking, you'll find me somewhere.
And I encourage you guys to go look for Mike's podcast, because he did an interview with a brilliant man who's been in the industry a long time, very knowledgeable, Gordon McGill, the man. He can take you from deregulation all the way up today. So go check out that interview in particular. Candace, where do they find you?
Real quick, spell Lombard, just in case anybody needs this. I know I'm not the best speller in the world, so.
Oh yeah, sorry. I should spell it out. You know, it's similar to the Super Bowl trophy, Lombardi, just without the I. So it's LOMBARD, Lombard Trucking. Yeah.
Absolutely. It. Sometimes that's one of my things. I always make myself feel better. I say, if you can't spell, you're smart. But I think that goes against itself. But it's all things. I'm Candace Rivers, and it's all things Fits Possible Trucking. So that's FITSPOSSIBLE Trucking, TRUCKING. And that comes from the scripture: with man, these things are impossible, but with God, all things are possible, because fit is possible trucking. And you can find me on Facebook as Candace Rivers. I have a like page too, but for some reason, a lot of people follow me more on my regular page. You can follow it, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. My biggest presence is on TikTok, which is Fits Possible Trucking. But again, you know, wherever you find media, hopefully you can find me. One of the things you can be looking for that I will be moving towards this year is creating basically media for y'all to come together and find all the resources that can help you thrive as a truck driver. From going from surviving out there to thriving. And, you know, that's the goal for me, is to launch a magazine that's geared towards the trucker, for the trucker. And it's all about how you can take every aspect of your life, financially, emotionally, relationally, physically, nutritionally, and talk to wonderful people like Mike and others, so that you have a wide variety of voices to get whatever you need to help you thrive while you drive.
Awesome. So now we're going to have a little bit of discussion, and you guys agreed to this little discussion. I'm going to let Tom open the subject up. So Tom, go ahead and tell everybody about the article and about the bill, and kind of let's pick this thing apart a little bit.
Alrighty. So just a little over 48 hours ago, near the end of the day, on Tuesday, two congressmen, Dusty Johnson, Republican from South Dakota, and Jim Costa, Democrat from California, not guys who normally hang out together, got together and have co-jointly sponsored a bill called the Safer Highways and Increased Performance for Interstate Trucking Act, the Ship It Act. And it's a sweeping overhaul of the interstate trucking supply chain system, is the way they describe it. Key provisions in this would include rather hefty tax credits for drivers, both who have been on the road for a while, and even better tax credits for new drivers. It also includes, and clarify something for you here, Charlie, $755 million over the next 4 years just for truck parking, not for the whole bill, just for truck parking. So that's interesting. The congressman said in their joint statement that they want to streamline the CDL process, and they also want to make it easier for states to grant exemptions when they have emergencies. So there's a lot of different parts to this bill. The folks over at OOIDA took a look at it, and they're they like it, they don't love it. And, you know, through them, they, let's see, we appreciate Representative Johnson's longtime support of expanding truck parking capacity and are glad he and Representative Costa recognize the importance of addressing the truck parking shortage to help keep drivers safe and improve supply chain performance. However, The bill misses the mark by failing to fix the underlying causes of driver retention problem in trucking, including a lack of adequate compensation from carriers and failure of shippers and carriers to value any of the truckers' time. And they go on to talk about what they don't like about the bill. So they like it, but it doesn't cover everything. Other industry folks, say the International Dairy Foods Association president, gushes all over it. And there are those who think it's awesome and others who find it, it's all right.
I find a couple of problems with it. With the streamlining the CDL process, anytime the government starts streamlining anything, it makes it worse. I don't understand what are they expecting, an influx of like millions of new drivers, and they want to streamline the process. Go back to what you just said about what OIDA said. OIDA is 100% right. You know, I'm the president of an organization that doesn't compete with OIDA, but we at NADRA do similar to what OIDA does. We lobby on behalf of our industry. I agree. You know, here's the problem. When the Department of Labor and the DOT have two different meanings, right? Department of Labor says you should be paid for all time you're at work performing job-related duties. Why is it the DOT says, well, when you're off duty, you're not working? But we're all encouraged to log off duty, do that 15-minute quick load, that 15-minute unload, but we sit places for 4 or 5 hours that we don't get paid for, Tom. I mean, so I agree with OIDA. You want to fix trucking? Don't change our rate of pay, right? And I'm sure Mike agrees. We don't want people telling you what you can make. What we should do is pay us for the things that you're not paying us for. That will improve our quality of life right off the bat and improve safety right away. Because if guys are getting paid for the 5 hours they sat at the dock, they're not going to feel pressured to make that time up by being distracted everywhere they drive, being in a rush, watching the clock, doing whatever. So I got to agree with that portion of it, with where OIDA, where Todd and Louie and the rest of them stand on that. We need to do something about that, all that time that we don't get paid for.
I love Louie, and I think Louie has a lot of wisdom. But here's my issue. There are so many things that bring down every bill. This bill right now is only 21 pages, which double-spaced. Okay, you can squeeze it all down a lot more than that. It's not a very long bill. And everybody and their brother will try and attach things to it and try to do different things with it. But here's the thing. This covers a whole lot of stuff that drivers have been looking for and talking about for a long time. The government has very little control over how you're going to get paid by your carrier. So here's what they're doing. They're going around your carrier and they're going to give you a tax break instead.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you're going to get money, but you're not. It may not be coming the way you think it ought to come, but it's a raise. I mean, you're going to have more money at the end of the year than you did at the beginning of the year. That's a raise. So that's a good thing.
Okay. That's a good thing. And question. Do they have it laid out with their streamlining with the CDL?
Oh, yeah. Because it's all laid out.
The only thing I will say is, as a person that recently got her CDL, the school that I went to has a year waiting list to go to their school.
Yeah, let me finish here. Okay. The point is, we don't get these kinds of bills to come around very often.
Mm-hmm. No, we don't.
And if we're going to get into nitpicking on these things, we're going to lose it all. Because somebody's going to look at it and go, yeah, I heard some truck drivers saying they're not supporting this, so I'm not going to be behind it.
We have other bills out there, though, and when it comes to the pay, getting the money in the form of a tax credit, and I'm speaking on a guy who knows owner operators and know guys who live load to load, and you know they're getting paid by brokers only every 30 days, however it may work. I really think the rising tide would be that other bill that's going on, the Guaranteeing Overtime for Truckers Act, which I think it'll incentivize the shippers and receivers to not keep guys sitting longer and the owner
this bill doesn't stop that bill. But if you try to attach them all together, they will find a reason to vote no.
Yeah, I do agree. When you start just nitpicking the ones and twos, I'm inclined to agree with OIDA's opinion on it. I think when it comes to streamlining the CDL process, like I said, that's why we have issues in this industry. I mean, we've lowered the standard in a lot of ways of receiving the CDL. I mean, we're taking people who've not even lived in this country for up to 6 months, and all of a sudden they're on Interstate 70 in the wintertime in Colorado after they went to a four-week school.
Yeah.
You know, these mega carriers are a churn and burn system, so that I don't think helps the industry, but we shouldn't let that stop the bill.
That's
you're right.
That's what I'm saying. You know, this has ATA. Mm-hmm. This has ATA written all over it. I get that. Okay, you know, ATA probably wrote it. You know, I get that. Okay, at least. But you know, the other bill about the labor adjustment, it's not there right now. It may it may never actually be introduced. All the bills that were there before January 1st, they're all gone. They don't exist. Okay, it's a new Congress, so everything's got to be reintroduced. So if they don't introduce it again, it ain't going to happen. Here's a bill that's been introduced. Quite frankly, I'm stunned that they got it in the first month. I didn't think anybody would pay attention for months, and this is one of the first bills out of the hopper. I you know, somebody's got to jump all over it. If it needs fine-tuning, fine-tune it. But at the same, you know, I think these guys need to be applauded and held up and said, okay, love what you're doing here.
On its face, it's the best I've seen in a long time
covering
the issues. Because for me, that truck parking thing, Mike Boss probably stepped back from his bill because the number is pretty much the same as what they were floating. The $755 million for truck parking can go a long ways to start fixing it. So you're right. You know, I may not agree with every aspect, Tom, but as a whole, yeah, this bill should be supported because it does cover some things we've wanted fixed, and this may be our opportunity to fix some.
It may be. And how many times is this opportunity going to come around? That's the question. And I think not often. So, you know, those of you who know this industry a lot better than I do, who live and breathe it every day, you need to download this thing. You can find it every website, you know, thetrucker.com, Landline Now, you know, all of them. They all have links back to the bill. Very easy read, 21 pages. Download it, get out your marker, and start saying, okay, I love it, but here's what needs to be adjusted. Get together, make sure that you all are singing basically the same song, and get it fixed. Otherwise, this just, it falls on deaf ears, and we know that there's a bunch of congressmen on both sides of the aisle who will vote no because they don't understand any of it, and yeah, whatever, that's too much money. I vote no on those things. So we've got to get those who do listen, the Babbins of this world, and you know, all these other guys who do listen.
Yes, sir.
And talk to them about, okay, we need a little adjustment here, need a little adjustment there. This is what we need to get it to so that it's good for everybody and not just something that's good for the big shippers. And this is, without question, good for the big shippers. What can we do to, you know, make it a little bit better? And maybe the entire section about streamlining the CDL needs to be pulled. I don't know. You guys need to read it for yourselves and decide, does this actually help us or not?
The parking is huge. I'd go as far as say that's the biggest thing. I mean, that's why people quit right there, just because of how the e-logs are. The part, not having a place to park, not being able to have a place to go, like not having access to a toilet. That right there causes people to abandon trucks and rage quit all the time. Yeah.
And you know what, Tom? This bill may open up the door to that conversation, right? Because we constantly say how the rules they create, they're stacked against us, right? So they come up with the e-log because they want to streamline paperwork. They want to make sure people are being honest. So we went to a computerized version. But the computerized version is fine. I don't have a problem with the device. I have a problem with a 14-hour clock. So Right. Maybe through conversation about how positive some of these things are in this bill by calling our representatives and opening a dialogue and speaking to them and these groups, you know, these groups all, like you said, I know NADRA is going to download it and go through it. I know OIDA's gone through it. I know that probably some of these other organizations that are out there are going to do it. Maybe now's the time we all put our heads together and stop worrying about who's got the biggest social media presence and say, hey, let's see what we can do with what we've got.
It's your opportunity to do exactly that. And the three of you, and TNC Radio too, but you have a voice. You have people who are listening to what you're saying. And, you know, this is the opportunity to come together. Look, you may not get 100% agreement, but if you can get enough agreement between enough people to at least make sure that our representatives hear the voice, you got a chance of getting this thing passed. There's a chance.
Oh, I'd like to see the $755 million for truck parking. But other than that, man.
I'll be sending an email to my congressman tomorrow. I have an email of somebody who works in his office, specifically on legislation, one of his staffers. And I sent him an email today. And like I said, I didn't know the SHIP Act was back. And I'm going to email him tomorrow and start calling. Absolutely. And I'm going to be telling everybody I know on the internet to start calling.
And if you use the TNCRadio.live app, remember, you can press the call us button. And one of your options is to be attached to the switchboard there in Washington, D.C. All you got to know is your zip code. Tell them what your zip code is, and they will connect you with your congressman, get to the office. Sometimes you even actually get to talk to the congressman, but you usually get to talk to somebody in the office and let them know what it is that you're thinking. And I think over the course of the next days and weeks, we need to get together and understand what is it, what's the message? What's the message?
And I think that that's going to be a great conversation for NADRA's roundtable this weekend. Maybe we should broach on this bill, Tom, and you know, have a discussion with the drivers about how they feel about the bill.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, but so, in the meantime,
we're out of time here. So, NADRA2022.com. You can learn more about that. Say one more time. Give us the best web address to learn more about your stuff, Candace.
BitsPossibleTrucking.com, and you can email me and get all the information you need. But anything, right, just Google FITS, Possible, POSSIBLE, and then Trucking, TRUCKING, and you will find your one-stop shop to find me.
And Mike, best place to follow your stuff?
Best place to follow me, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Lombard Trucking, Lombard Trucking. You can also find my podcast, The Lombard Trucking Show, wherever you get your podcasts.
Fantastic. You've got 15 seconds. Anything else you want to?